could see yourself just sitting there on my chair. I'm staring at you, you don't even notice. Should have told you straight away, you don't have to be afraid.
A little dark, a little cold outside. A little workbench outside the house. And I've cut the edges off and drilled the holes for the sink. And then I just got finished. Sorry about my heating and air conditioner. It just kicked on. I took this and I made the waterfall. The sink's going to cover all this. So started right there and made a waterfall. Cover it. Now I gotta, I don't know if you can, yeah, you can see it. I'll have to sand that. So that's what I'm getting ready to do. My sander. So I have to sand it all, make it all smooth. It's just got a little hump right there. All right. Let's get back to work. Got this done. It's a cabinet that goes above the sink. It's like a vanity. It's all cedar. Everything's done. I'll give you a closer look of it. It's got three shelves on it. Bring it out so you can see it all. It's protected by the dog. I think the dog went to sleep on me. But anyway, there's that. I still got a polyurethane in it, and in the middle we'll have there'll be a mirror for the middle. So there's that. Alright, so first coat of polyurethane's on it. I'm going to let it dry. I'll let you look at it all since it's done. And there's that one. You can see the redness. There's a little bit more. This will come off, by the way. That's just there to hold it until I get it together. See how shiny it is. But there it is. Finally got it all sanded, and I wiped off the top. I put tape around the edges to give me my height. I'll put tape around that. I've got tape on the bottom to cover all these knots. I'm getting ready to pour. So bring you over here. There's the brand epoxy I'm using, and I'm using I think it's Pearl X. And it's turquoise to do the waterfall. So I'll set you down here and then I'll start stirring it, mixing it up, and then we'll get ready to pour. Just to stir for 2 minutes in this one, then pour it back in that, and then stir it for another minute. Hope y'all can see that. It's been 2 minutes, so now I gotta pour it all in here. And then I gotta get another stir stick, which I have. I gotta flip sides. And that's why I put that paper underneath, because that little spot just dripped and I didn't want it dripping on my table. I mixed in the blue a second ago. And there, it's been a minute stirring, but I'm going to stir it a little bit more to make sure this blue's stirred up good in it. Here we go. There's a little bit paper towel where I wiped off right there. Get that out. I guess I'll start with the big side. Ooh, run down in there. What I'm going to do with this is I'm going to use this and just pull this down to make that even right there. And I messed up and I do two things at once. That is pretty much even across the board. So I don't know if you can see this. Let me come back at the camera. I just got a heat gun and you can see the bubbles. I don't know if you can see the bubbles. Because, yeah, there you go. I'll set my tripod back down so that way you can do it. So all I'm going to do is try to get rid of those bubbles. I'll get you zoomed in as close as I can. That way you can see it. I'm just going to go quick here. I'm not going to hold it over. You see the bubbles disappear, so I'm going to go back over it until they're all gone. So you see? You see them disappear. So I'm not trying to blow it. I'm just trying to get the bubbles out. Just like that. It's been a day and a half, and we're ready to make the final pour over top of that. You can see, I get you zoomed in. See how pretty that is. It's beautiful. So basically, I just have to mix them two together, the resin, the hardener, stir it for 3 minutes, and that's it. So let me get you set up, and we'll be right back. The resin's a lot thicker than the hardener. So I'm gonna let this sit up here until I pour this in here. I'm gonna look and just see how much is in there. ounces in that, so if I add this, and it should be 28 ounces. There it is. Let me get the stirring. It's been 3 minutes. So I'm just counting. I'm going to do about another 10 seconds. I know I set the timer to 3 minutes, but I just want to make sure. I only have one shot at this, and this stuff's expensive. I'm just stirring up the bottom, too. Move the plastic. I'm in my daughter's room, so I don't have my tripod, so it's hard to do this by myself. So I can't do it all. I'm just recording some of it. So I'm gonna put this on here. So I'm just showing you a little bit, 20 seconds or so, and then I'm gonna turn you off, and then we'll come back. All right, we'll be back. I don't know if I can get the whole thing in or not, but I'll try to. You see the light? That's how shiny it is. You see Amber's light right there. Now, basically, all you want to look for is just low spots, and I don't see any. I think I've got them all. That's why I had to put the camera down. You just want to look for low spots because this stuff don't move like water. It's real thick, like molasses. So if there's a low spot, what you have to do is just get like that brush or get you something to spread it. They also have that right there to use with it. So anyway, we're gonna look out for bubbles. No, you can't see, there's a little bubble right there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take that heat gun and just like Kirsty, you can't see it. And I'm going to use that heat gun to kind of just get the bubbles out and move quickly with it. So we'll be right back.
Yeah, I'm going to take my through the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse through the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.